on the season. Just 29% from the floor. Seton Hall wins the opening tip, and the Pirates go to work first. So we take a look at the starters for the Seton Hall Pirates. Lauren Park Lane going to work right away on the floor with Hagans, Pinckney, Bembry, and Jordan. And there you see the Georgia starters, as we do have a change to the starting five for Georgia. Choi Clapman, Chloe Chapman is not available today for Georgia per SEC rules. She was kicked out of yesterday's game with a technical foul. As Park Lane, another basket inside. Your starters for Georgia today: Battles, Lewis, Smith, Warren, and Nicholson. The first five out.
Lewis has been sensational off the bench for the Bulldogs, number 23.
It's a feed ahead to Hagans. Hagans now in the corner. It's rebounded by Brittany Smith. Smith, a senior for Georgia, transferred over from UCF following head coach Katie Abrahamson and Henderson, and currently sits at 999 career points.
What a play by Hagans, coming from the backside, tipping that possession. Good start for the Pirates.
Park Lane, oh, that is a deep three. Feeling it after making her first two baskets of the game.
Slow start for Park Lane in that first game when they lost to VCU, but
10th season brought Sidney Cooks off the bench yesterday for the first time of the season. Will do the same today as she played with good energy.
Cooks has to play well. She is an all Big East performer. I'm going to bring off the bench, but as a big part of our game plan is Sidney Cooks.
And she's that player that Coach Bozella says needs to be our third consistent score. There's an in-and-out miss by Warren.
That was going to be one of my keys, is Baines has to play well off the bench for the Pirates.
Alicia Lewis with the basketball. She has played well off the bench for Georgia. Gets the start here today.
Has been tremendous in this tournament.
As Nicholson follows her own shot. The offensive rebound and put back. And it's Nicholson scoring the first four for Georgia.
Quick lateral, took up a lot of space. Lewis has to step into that spot. Plug up that high post area.
Baines draws the foul.
The physical presence.
With a two-point lead over Georgia. Here's Warren. Out to Lewis. She's deadly from outside. And
when Coach made her move from UCF, Coach Katie Abrahamson Henderson. Here's the thing now. I look at these stats. Lewis came the game prior to this against Georgia Tech. She didn't score a point before this tournament. At 0 points in one game. Big breakout here at the Paradise Jam.
Catch and shoot three. Georgia getting it going back-to-back triples on the offensive end. In front for the first time today.
Three ball is big for the Bulldogs. The cavity in their game. They knock it in threes. Watch out, SEC. Be hard to beat.
Hagans out to Park Lane. And wow, Park Lane.
Keep an eye on Park Lane, the top of the key. We can get her some shots up there against this Bulldog zone.
Here's Warren. Knocks in the three from the corner.
High octane game. There we go. Sydney. That's a soft spot in that zone.
Sidney Cooks, 9 points yesterday in just 14 minutes coming off the bench for Seton Hall. The miss by Bates. And now Bembry running the floor. A little runner from the free throw line, and it falls. Lane, no. Offensive rebound. Guess who? Nicholson, the kick out. Battles a set and shoot three. No. Warren, the putback. Makes it look easy. Disqualified today by the SEC.
That was a separate incident with Chloe Chapman later in the game. Big front line for the Bulldogs. Big back line.
Backdoor cut and the finish. K-Sack with the basket.
You got to get some points from some unexpected players. That was a big basket there by Satterfield.
Satterfield playing just 3 minutes or less in each of the first two games.
Through the transfer portal. Know her system. Players like Nicholson stuck around to join this crew.
Four players from UCF on this Georgia team as Cooks.
She's planting her flag right there.
There's Nicholson inside, blocked by Cooks, and a foul called.
Aren't flashy.
This is her fourth year at Georgia, and sticking with Coach Abe during the coaching change. And there's Zoesha Smith. She's also been a Bulldog for a few years.
Offensive rebound and a missed free throw. That drives coaches into
Sidney Cooks. The smooth looking jumper from the baseline. There's battles at the horn.
Both teams wearing their dark uniforms.
Kind of like the red. And battles averages 14 points on the seat.
Bulldog defense.
And Audrey Warren, an excellent start for Georgia. 8 points, 2 assists. She's 3 of 7, has a couple of three-pointers from that first quarter. As we are tied at 23. Lewis with a three-pointer already. Battles banked one in from that same spot. Finds her groove. And Georgia applies that full-court pressure defense.
Well, they've already got 5 triples. That's huge.
Hagans, a catch and shoot.
With that power. This is bully ball now. You got to bully them right back.
Here's Hagans, gets the rebound on the tip out. Park Lane back to Hagans.
That's
for the
why
three.
They're difficult to press.
Opens up the driving lane now. Hagans the floater. And that rebound pulled in by Jordan Isaacs. Battles. A little step left. Three ball. Good.
That makes this Georgia team a top 25 team, they start making triples.
Smith attacking the rim, comes up with the second opportunity. And Georgia not giving up any offensive rebounds on the other end of the floor. Battles the jumper.
Both teams feeling each other out, want to know how the official is going to call it.
There's a steal.
Quick defense.
Amari Wright on the run. The dump off Satterfield. Nice hands and the lay-in.
Field goal percentage means nothing in this game.
Battles gets bumped. She'll have 3 free throws come. Seasons at UCF last year. The American Athletic Conference Player of the Year.
At a shelf in the living room for all the.
That low block one more time. Gets it inside. Turnaround shot in and out. No. And Seton Hall wins the rebound battle.
Brittany Smith is long and a quick jumper. Not able to convert that time. Her recovery's in the zone.
Oh, Park Lane and an and one.
Comes out of there quick. So even though she's 5'3", and she has played, she told us, you know, I played against guys all the time growing up that were bigger and stronger than me. I learned how to get my shot off against bigger, stronger players at a very young age.
Brittany Smith, her first year at Georgia. Here's Cooks dumping inside. Satterfield, the shot, no. And the rebound grabbed by Warren, and then the bump.
And Coach Abe both understand we're in November. 50-50 balls.
The free throw's good by Warren. Warren with a double figure. Satterfield gets the lay-in.
That is a highlight film pass. That's a Sports Center pass.
Here's a steal by Wright. Amari Wright's going to challenge Battles. Gets the lay-in.
Call for the screen. Park Lane.
Here's Jordan. Jordan from the corner for the traveling violation, and Seton Hall gets it right back.
Another turnover by the Dogs.
Satterfield, what a feed inside. Jordan able to finish. Back to the action here. We begin the third quarter. Georgia basketball. It was a fun first half between these two teams. And Brittany Smith, the first point.
Hey, Smith. I like Smith. Good-looking player.
Averages 11 points per game, second most on this team. Behind Battles right there. Oh, Nicholson cool. Dumps it off the extra pass.
Wow.
Monster game.
Iron Woman played the full 20 minutes and snatching another rebound.
That's her fourth of this game. Here's Warren, dumps it off. Smith, oh, tough shot, gets it to fall.
Seeing a running game from the Bulldogs.
Here's Bembry. Bembry in the lane.
He is Elmer's glue on steroids.
Jordan the rebound. Here comes Park Lane. Ahead to Bembry.
Yes.
Off the window.
Just off the fingertips.
Here comes Battles. Alicia Lewis to Smith. Smith, the jumper.
Brad, you turn around at 10 feet with a defender in your face, ball up above your forehead. Big time basket.
The floater by Park Lane.
They know their identity, and they don't vary from it.
The jumper from Alou. Smith trying to feed it inside. Nicholson, good hands, out to Battles. One dribble, pull up, Jake. So back into the game, Audrey Warren. And here's another Seton Hall turnover.
Lewis pokes it loose.
And Jerisha Smith gets the lay-in. Nice move for the opposition.
I played for a Hall of Fame high school coach in the state of Iowa. And same concepts. Pressed all the time. He said, it's going to happen in the fourth quarter. It's going to happen in spurts. Need a bucket badly.
Sidney Cooks back in the game, fires the three from the corner, and the rebound grabbed by Alicia Lewis.
I know Cooks can make them, and I know you like her shooting those threes, but I want her inside.
Smith rattles it home. 21 points, 10 rebounds against Georgia Tech for Zoesha Smith.
Here's your gift to the Pirates. You got to quit shooting those, even though I'm going to say take that. Getting it inside and getting the free throw line. You got to disrupt the rhythm. Here we go.
Here's a run out. Amari Wright takes it to the rack, gets the foul called on Britt. Coach Abe on the Georgia sideline. He's created this 6-point lead. Here comes Seton Hall, quick on the inbounds. Cooks fires the jumper.
Georgia got caught running back, half speed with their heads down. And you know, we saw that Park Lane with the push. Pirates, they went tempo.
Oh, what a feed from Battles.
Role you should put in basketball 101 film.
There's Warren defending the backdoor cut. Nicholson feeds to Smith. So smooth, the catch and shoot.
You know what happened first, Brad? Smith got to the block. She got to the real estate she wanted. Smith is a rim runner.
Park Lane, oh my, that's her fourth. Seton Hall getting 17 points from Lauren Park Lane. Diamond Battles, one better with 18. Battles coming away around the corner. Georgia has seen Brittany Smith come alive here in this second half. 12 points for Brittany Smith. She had two at halftime.
Same play we saw earlier, that on the right wing, just a two-man pick-and-roll play with Lewis and Nicholson. Lewis gets the paint. And you tell your guard in a situation, if you don't pass it to your roll, get your feet in the paint and good things will happen.
Sidney Cooks knocks in another. Jordan the kick out, Wright for three. Long rebound to Amari Wright. Now Cooks inside, the shot and an and one coming. Foul on Isaac.
Coach Abe just dejected after those last three calls.
That won't fall for Nicholson. Nice putback inside. Fantastic stat line for her in this game. Battles, loses it, and throws it away. Here comes Wright. Wright and Hagans. Hagans, the lay-in, yes.
There's been worse. That by the book, that's the correct call. But if somebody called that to you in the driveway, oh, high-low, baby.
Turkey leftovers. Back home. He's Kevin Lehman. I'm Brad Wells. This is a good game right in front of us here.
Well, these are two excellent, excellent coaches. The suspension of a major player, Chloe Chapman. Lewis, there's been no letdown with Lewis in this lineup.
Jumper from the baseline.
Wow, is this woman fast?
Hagans takes it to the rim. Transfer from Penn State in her first season with the Pirates.
The steals that create easy baskets and fills the weak side lane with sprinter speed if there's a steal on the other side of the court. Hagans can fly.
Battles dumps it off for Isaacs. A steal,
three triples.
Foul on Bembry was her first. One of two at the line for Isaac.
And it's leaving that open hole in the high post. We've seen the Pirates attack time and time again. There she is.
Well, she gets an open look, yeah. And that's her fifth made three-point.
Georgia lost track of Park Lane. And here she comes again. They lost track of her during that inbounds play.
And she is 8-for-11 shooting from the three-point line. 5-of-7.
Smith back in. They're looking high-low. There's that quick release. I told you.
Screen by Bembry, and Smith knocks the ball away and comes up with the steal.
That is an all-SEC player, number 24.
Well, Coach, we've seen at Georgia's defense wear teams down in that second half. We'll see if the final held to just 7 points, but still had 6 rebounds, 6 assists. Now Park Lane wants it. Has an open look from three. In and out. No. Warren the rebound.
That dipped in. Looked like one of my putts. Whoa, I told you. Still playing with one shoe. Isaacs. Still playing with one shoe. Here it comes.
There you go. Slip it on.
Love it.
I think her heel is still not in that shoe. No, it's in. There's Battles, gets bumped, and will go to the line for two. Diamond Battles for season high.
Seton Hall is shooting 58% from the field. They've got fewer shots, but they've been more efficient.
Lauren Park Lane dribbles out of trouble. Now in the lane, dumps it off to Cooks. Cooks muscles it up, gets it to fall. Warren will try and tie it. Rebound to Wright.
The Bulldogs have gone away from their inside game.
At the charity stripe.
Amar Wright has played exceptionally everywhere defensively.
And too big late for...
I think she's going to foul it.
Listed at 6'3", but you're saying can play as though she's 6'4". Flat-footed, reaching straight up.
Yes. Means a wingspan also. Brittany Smith's a good example of that.
Seton Hall up threes, trying to work the clock, but turns it over. Now battles on attack mode. Poked away by Park Lane. After Seton Hall up just three, you can work a little bit of clock, but you cannot afford to turn it over. Now they'll work to get a shot. Park Lane, a kick to the corner. Hagans. Oh, my. Sha'Lynn Hagans, the three from the corner. 35 to play. Nicholson looking for battles, throws it away. Another steal by Wright. And the foul is going to send Seton Hall back to the line. Remember, if Seton Hall wins, there'd be three teams that would be 2-1. Seton Hall needing to win by eight or more, we're told, to claim the Island Division Championship. First free throw is good. As long as you can secure the win. Free throw is missed.
Three possession game. Take away the three.
Battles fires the three, knocks it in. Battles with 23. Back to a 5-point deficit.
That would allow the defense full court pressure.
Under 15, Georgia going for the steal. Now Park Lane is going to get fouled by Jamari Flournoy.
Their fundamentals of passing and catching are excellent. Spacing. Coach Boz has this team well prepared.
Flournoy into battles. Battles kicks Zoesha Smith, called for the travel.
Seton Hall had to win the turnover battle because Georgia was going to win the rebound battle on the offensive glass.